For me, you want to find your mouth. Because when you post this stuff on your story and this and this and that, so I'm going to give you a fair one. So get up there and run my husband. I want to run my husband, you know that. You know that. I told you I'm going to pull up. You post on your story. Me and my husband, you said this stuff.
Yes, what I said is what I said, and that's exactly what we're going to be reacting to. And of course, I know you guys are going to be looking for the video down below. I'm actually going to leave it this time so you guys can watch it on your own time. For obvious reasons, I'm going to be cutting out a lot of parts in this reaction due to violence and a whole bunch of other crap that I don't need here on this channel. I hope you guys missed me. I just landed from Costa Rica. Thank you so much for the well wishes for me and my mans or whatever. I flew him out for his birthday. We had such a great time. It was a surprise trip and he didn't really know about it. So super great. Thank you guys so much for all the kind comments on Instagram and on YouTube on my community tab. I really don't post my personal business. Costa Rica was fun. Check out the vlog if you haven't already. Carded up above or linked down below. And he says, thank you so very much for the birthday wishes, the mafia. So thank you guys for that. And thank you guys for all the kind comments. So of course it's time to get back to work. So let's get into it. This video was actually a video that I found on my own. However, if you ever want to send me a video, I do have a video suggestion form, but it will get to me faster if you send it in my The Mafia Discord, which is a huge The Mafia group chat. There's different servers on there, including a debate room, a music room, and all types of different stuff. I also always post in there when I post a new video. You can also follow me on Instagram, Facebook, Snapchat, MySpace. I'm not, I don't have a Snapchat and MySpace is dead, right? But you get the point, guys. You guys can follow me and make sure you guys check out the description box for all of the information that you guys always ask me for in the description box all the time. Make sure you guys cop your merchandise and most importantly, follow me on Bego. I go live all the time impromptu. Like I'll be singing, dancing, doing all types of stuff on there. So if you don't catch me, I'm sorry. Ain't no replays and I'm not re-uploading though. And of course, comment down below. Has anyone ever tried to fight you and your mama, or did you ever try to fight somebody and a mama? Because honestly, I find this absolutely ridiculous and I don't even understand what type of ratchet ghetto behavior this is, but we're gonna get straight into the reaction because I need to understand this type of tomfoolery fuckery that I'm seeing right now. I have pants on, by the way, guys. Don't say that I'm on here naked, okay? Don't try to say I'm on here with no clothes on. Don't be telling y'all mama, y'all daddy that I'm out here doing rude and crude acts on the internet. Now, a fair warning, because you guys are gonna most likely click on this video and probably be triggered by the title and whoever posted this. So the reason this person posted it was to try to prove a point that black women are portrayed as masculine for things like this. And to be quite honest, this has absolutely nothing to do with black women being portrayed as masculine. This is straight hood rat disgusting ass behavior and has nothing to do with black women being masculine. I know plenty of feminine women that was out here beating the shit out of bitches, okay? This has a lot to do with poor parenting, lack of resources, and the fact that men, black men and black women love to point the blame at one another and love to bitch, cry, and complain, saying that each other is the blame for shit and never taking accountability and responsibility. Shut the fuck up, get some therapy, get some fucking help, and stop blaming each other for your damn problems. And when you are gonna put the damn blame, make sure you blame yourself as well. And when you are gonna make these damn videos, also make sure that you point out the problem on both sides, okay? All right.
So if she, bro, I'm just gonna get my one with her. Let's
be in the window though.
Well, I want my one with her here because let me show you how she tested me, bro.
Oh, We just want to fight her one time and we'll leave, please.
And then not even all of us.
Just one time. We're not even going to jump
you. You know, you text me and said I know where you stay.
We're not even trying to jump you, Adair. Just one thing, please. We'll leave you alone.
I'm sorry. This is just freaking pathetic. Who begs to fight somebody? Like, honestly, I've been there, done that in this whole ratchivity phase where it's like, you really have to get it out there. Like, when you really want to fight somebody, like, you know, you just have to get it over with. I get that. But literally pulling up to somebody's house, literally being bold enough to pull up to somebody's face, like, oh my God, let me fight you. Oh my God, just one fade. Oh my God, just let me do this. It's really, really pathetic, really, really disgusting, and really, really unnecessary. I don't even understand why they think it's okay to do this and why they're not embarrassed. Are you not embarrassed? Like, where's your homework? Where's your morals? Where's your standards? Where's your parents? I'm not understanding what I'm watching here. I'm confused. I'm utterly confused. I'm assuming everybody in this chat is from the same area. And I'm assuming everybody knows who these people are. And this is the problem with hood culture that I don't like. There's a lot of bad things that could happen here. I'm gonna watch this and then I'm gonna give my opinions in the end on that. But it annoys me that all these people think this is funny. All I see is laughing emojis. All I see is people egging this shit on. But God forbid something would have really happened. Somebody would have got shot, stabbed, bleached on their face. All of a sudden, this shit would have been a hashtag justice for ta-ta-ta, right? But y'all egging this shit on. Y'all think this shit funny. No snitching, right? Why nobody calling the cops? Why nobody trying to intervene and stop this shit? Why everybody egging this shit on? Why? Why? And this girl obviously not trying to vibe. Like, this is really annoying. This is really, really, like, ridiculous. Why do y'all have nothing to do? This is why I tell y'all, put y'all kids in sports. Put y'all kids in extracurricular so they don't have time to do this type of shit. Okay, they don't have time to go around antagonizing people. They don't have time to go around being hood rat dusty ass kids. This is real hood rat dusty ass kids. This is the future felons, the future statistics, the future baby mothers, the future convicts, the future bad motherfuckers of America. And I'm not even saying that just because they black. We're being real now. If this was white people, I would have said the same fucking shit. This is the future statistics of America.
Zaria! I'm not gonna find this lady window with the hair.
You gonna come over there?
No, open that motherfucker.
Did I just run up in the house?
Close the window. We here, y'all. We in the house, y'all. We in the house. Boy.
Nah, I'm sorry. I would have ripped that Ronald McDonald wig off his head because she mad smug, mad happy. She mad slick. She got that mad ass grip ass smirk on her face like, yeah, we in the house, y'all. No. At that point, I have every right to do whatever it is that I want to because now you're in my house. I have no idea why whoever in the world lives in this house, and I know it can't just be the girl and the mom, and even if it was, why they're not more outraged by this. Why I don't hear no screaming. I don't hear no, I'm calling the cops. Why y'all just let these girls in your house? I'm perplexed.
What you gonna do? We have finished, mother.
Oh, y'all bold.
What you gonna do? We ain't here, though.
No,
we ain't here, though. We ain't here though.
Oh, y'all bold.
We ain't here though.
Oh, y'all bold.
We ain't here though. We ain't here though. Y'all try to say we wasn't gonna be here. We ain't here though.
Who wasn't? No, y'all. Tell me again. Not Marjorie.
We ain't this motherfucker though. Oh, God.
Mom, are you not more outraged that people are trying to attack understand. Y'all, I'm outraged. I'm really outraged. And then fourth of all, this is over some shit that the girl said on Snapchat. This is literally the definition of pull up or shut up. Like, they literally pulled up because the girl said some shit on Snapchat. Like, y'all, like, when people be saying, oh, yeah, you know, when I see you, I didn't think when I see you means I'm gonna pull up in your house. Like, this is trespassing. This is legitimate trespassing. Like, you cannot do this. This is illegal. This is illegal. And I guarantee you that this is probably not gonna go well. Clearly, we know what we're gonna react to, right? But, like, what? Bro, I want to know what kind of dog they have so I know not to get it, because this dog not loyal at all. The dog not even trying to protect them whatsoever. What kind of dog is this? This dog is not loyal. The dog is not trying to protect them at all. The dog not trying to protect her. Her mom not trying to protect her. Where's the father? Where's the brother? Where's the cousin? Where's the uncle? Where's somebody? This doesn't make any logical sense. And even if there is no man in the household, where's the weapons to protect yourselves? If you're going to be living in your house by yourself, you need a camera. You need a weapon of some sort. You need something. You cannot just let people walk up in your house and do shit like this to you. I'm confused. I'm in confusion. Hey. They had to have been Haitian. Machete would have been all swinging left and fucking right. All their heads would have been rolling right out that fucking door. Kid you the fuck not. Right here, this is a big girl, okay? This is a real big girl compared to that girl, and I'm sure maybe that girl got the hands and all, but like, this just looks really, really bad. The girl does not want to fight. She does not want you in her home, even though clearly they just sitting down and putting up with it. But like, you guys literally trespass into her home after she said she didn't want to fight. Now you're standing over her telling her, oh, just one thing, oh, I want to fight, I can knock your head off right now. Excuse me. This is not fair. This is bullying, and you look real, real disgusting. Why do y'all think this is okay? And then whoever's recording this is just pissing me off, because all they're doing is not only they're recording this and reposting, but they're sitting there, they're posting laughing emojis. They're like, everybody's just thinking this is funny. This is not funny, because something very serious could have happened, and this could have been any of you guys. Well, clearly, let's be real now. I'm not even gonna say this could have been any of you guys, because to be honest, any rational person would not let this happen. As soon as they would have came in the house, they would have got stabbed up, shot up, something would happen. I don't understand how this happened. Anyone with logical sense would have literally kicked them right out physically with force, and it probably would have ended out 10 times worse. The fact that they're so calm with these people just walking in their house is unheard of. This would have ended 10 times worse if it had been any normal person. Let's just say that. But this right here is wild.
You said pull that butt right here. You said pull that butt.
Did she just slap her? There's a kid present. Y'all, I can't even keep track of everything that's wrong with this video. There's too many problems with this video. The mom's not trying to protect her. She doesn't want to fight. Somehow she let these people in. No one is really trying to get them out. They're recording this. Everyone in the chat thinks this is funny. There's no men in this household. There's no weapons in this household to get these people out. Like, I think I missed a couple hundred things, but there's so many problems wrong with this video right now. Why? This is why, bro. We not gonna go nowhere, bro. This hood culture, this ghetto-ness shit, this is, what the fuck is this? Why does everybody think this is funny? This is not funny. The fact that people are really commenting on this like, hee hee ha ha, and I'm sure it's a whole bunch of kids, and that's not an excuse to think that this is funny. That is not an excuse to let this slide. That is not an excuse to look at this and think it is acceptable. acceptable behavior. Because it is not. I'll be damned if I raise a kid and they ain't alive and they think this shit is funny. This is not funny. This is not funny by any means. That people put way too much emphasis on people talking shit about them, okay? I talk shit all day. People talk shit about me all day. You don't see me bitching, crying, and complaining when someone says something about me because I don't really give a fuck. I was born with a nonchalant factor. It's as if, like, God didn't sprinkle that within me. I don't understand why it bothers people that much when people talk shit about them. If that person's not your friend or your family or someone you consider close, it really shouldn't bother you that bad that you take it to the extent of legitimately breaking the law and committing assault. Okay, someone talks shit about you, especially when you guys are already not friends, it should not be that deep. Who the fuck cares? People are gonna talk about you your entire life. You can't really do much about it. You need to be able to cope with that. Because at the end of the day, not everyone's gonna like you. Not everyone loves Mother Teresa. Not everyone loves Jesus. Okay? It doesn't matter how good or bad of a person you are. There's always gonna be someone that doesn't like you. And there's always gonna be people out there that talk shit about you. Now, clearly, we don't know the situation. However, this is so fucking extra. I'm sure these people were not friends. These girls were definitely not friends before this. Let's be real. Because if they were, it would not be this goddamn deep. So, I never can understand how people could genuinely not be friends and then literally get mad when they hear that the other person's talking shit about them. Like, it doesn't make sense. Like, oh, keep my name out your mouth. You know I don't fuck with you. What the fuck are you talking about? You don't fuck with me. So I'm gonna say what the fuck it is that I wanna say. I don't like you and you don't like me. And those people be the same ones talking shit about the other person. They really be doing the most. Oh, don't talk shit about me. Keep my name out your mouth. Rah, rah, rah. I don't even be thinking about you. Yes, you do. Because if you didn't, we wouldn't be having these problems. Because I kid you not, people that do this type of shit literally be thinking about you. This is way too much work. This is orchestrated as hell. No one who goes through all of this trouble to literally maim someone in the comfort of their home has not been thinking about you. This is a deep level of hatred, and it's just disgusting all levels and all fronts. Okay, nobody could tell me that somebody like this can sit there and say, oh, nobody think about you, don't talk about me, da da da. No, this is bullshit. Absolute caca caca bullshit. Confused? Is her mom in shock? Is her mom paralyzed? I will be damned. I literally would have ripped all of those kids' heads off, bruh. I don't got time and I don't play about any of the kids that I love, period. Let alone if I had my own, would I let something like this happen? This is mad wild. Like, they're literally, honestly, all of this talking is annoying. Okay, let's be real. All this talking is annoying. And the fact that they're doing all this talking and no one had the time to quote gaps.
Okay, get a job because you sitting here talking to the bitch.
is so fucking annoying. If you're so bothered and all of this extra shit, you do it yourself. Like, this girl, this type of girl right here is the type of girl you do not need in your friend group. This is the type of girl that you don't want around you. This is the type of girl that will literally get your ass in jail. Okay? She's the type of girl that could probably get your ass killed. She's got a loud ass mouth. She's literally the ringleader of all of this shit. And I'm very sure she orchestrated and literally propelled all of this shit to get as bad as it is right now. Watch out for people like this. This is very, very dangerous. And honestly, I guarantee you this would not have gotten this bad if it wasn't for her running her damn mouth the entire time, antagonizing this girl to go and beat this girl up in the comforts of her own home. Like,
You asked me easy.
Yeah, no. She's been over. She's been.
You should have told me to pop out and bounce. Hey, 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 hey,
hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, things are handled accordingly by the people that these things happen to. People take matters into their own hands. People, you know, get retaliation or whatever the case may be. And the problem with this is almost always someone that is innocent always gets hurt in the process. And a lot of this just always makes us look 10 times worse. And for the most part, a lot of this is for a whole lot of nothing that doesn't need to be a thing. Like, I personally don't even understand the entire caca that I just watched right now. Why the fuck is it that they thought that it made sense to even go in that house and do what they did and then walk out clean, scot-free? I'm really mad that no one intervened in that. Not one person in that live, not the mom the entire time they were sitting there popping all that shit, not anyone else that probably lived in that house. I'm mad that there was a kid present and they didn't care. Like, I just... If shit would have got to the point where someone got killed, next thing you know, it would have been justice for dot, dot, dot. And this would have been a whole polished, clean-cut story. Or probably wouldn't have even been talked about or been recorded or even put on YouTube. Because at that point, niggas would have been acting like it was something that doesn't need to be talked about because it was something that happened in the hood, right? Because it wasn't a white person doing it or because a cop didn't do it, no one would have been talking about it. I really hate this type of narrative. And I honestly feel like that's something that needs to be talked about. We need to stop doing crazy, stupid, violent, disgusting things to each other. Because it doesn't really put us in a good light, and that doesn't really help anything that is going on right now, and it doesn't really serve us any type of good. Honestly, I will say that the girl shouldn't have been talking shit, but I will say that she did not deserve that. If anything, they could have waited for her another time if they really wanted to fight, if that was the case. Going into her house is a little bit much, a little bit extra, and just way out of hand. I believe charges should have been pressed. I believe those girls should have been in jail. And in terms of street justice, they really should have got their asses handed to them one by one for all of that. I don't even understand why the camera girl even had her hair tied up or anything, because she didn't fucking do anything but scream, yell, antagonize, and egg the situation on. And to be quite honest with you, they're all pussy, they all punks, and they're all extra, and they're all not going to do anything with their lives. I guarantee you, they're going to be the future statistics of America. No one with anything going on for them and their lives who's going anywhere positive acts like that as a teenager. I know there's a lot of troubled teens that end up going on a straight and narrow, but not many. And I guarantee you those kids ain't going fucking anywhere. Comment down below, have you ever gotten into a fight that happened at your house? What happened? Why did it happen? What did you do? Did your parents have to defend you? I'd love to hear it down below. Also, make sure you guys like, share, subscribe, join the Discord server, follow me on Instagram, get your merchandise, and just peep the description box for anything you might have missed. Like, share, subscribe. I do have the video link down below, and I'm gonna see y'all next time. Bye!